Hello everyone, welcome back to Geek Disorder's series on HTML5, CSS3, JavaScript, and jQuery. This is Lavik. I'll be walking you through this series. This is our fifth video. This video is going to be going over how to install Firefox, the web browser. We're going to go over a little bit on how to install it and how to use it. Alright, well the first thing we need to do is we need to go to Google. Alright, and we're just going to search up Firefox, and one of the first links will be Mozilla Firefox web browser. Click on that and we're just going to click the download and it'll start downloading for us. I'm going to open it and I'm going to press install. Okay, while that's doing that, there's a few other of course browsers out there, i.e. Internet Explorer, there's Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Opera, stuff like that. I picked Firefox because it's pretty good for editing web pages and stuff like that, and also once we get into JavaScript it has a few advantages there. Alright, and I don't want to import anything. Click next and it's going to ask me if I want to set Firefox to my default browser, which I don't want to do. I use Google Chrome for most of my web browsing, but I use Firefox for most of my like JavaScript and stuff like that. So, and that's what we're going to be using in this series. So I'm going to tell it not to always perform this task and we'll click no. Alright, so right here we got Firefox. Just a few basic things you need to know to operate a web browser. Most of you probably already know this, but I'm going to go over the basics just in case. This right here is your address bar. It's where you can enter an address. You can also enter something to search. We're going to go to Google. So we're just going to press in google.com and we're at the Google web page. From here we're going to just search up something on Google. We're going to search up a web page over, HTML5. Alright, and we have a Wikipedia. We're going to go to W3Schools. Alright, so we have here's our web page over HTML5, the new web standard, or will be in 2014. A few things you'll want to be doing, like if you find a web page you like, you want to see like how they laid it out, what their HTML5 looks like, or their CSS, maybe some JavaScript. You can right click on the web page, so we're off to the side, just not on the link. And view web view page source. In another little window, it'll open up and give you the HTML5, CSS, and JavaScript code on that page. And you can see right here, here's all the HTML5 or HTML code that this page is made out of. So it's a little handy tool, and you can do that with any browser, just about. And it's a little handy tool to, if you find something, a neat trick they did or something, you can actually look at their code, at least on client side stuff. Server side stuff you cannot, but all your client side HTML5, CSS, and JavaScript you can. Alright, and as you can see, they have JavaScript. Doesn't look like they have a external JavaScript file, one that's off, but we do have a CSS. If you see something underlined like a CSS file, that means that code is linked on this HTML5, but in order to see it you gotta click, it'll take you to that new file, and here's their CSS. Okay, well this is Lavik. Thank you for joining us for this video of our HTML5, CSS3, JavaScript, and jQuery. Please, if you like the videos, please like or share, subscribe to the channel, and help us get the videos out there. Alright, and I'll see you all in the next one.